then you get a lot of walkers up on the summit, so it could be.
I hope you enjoyed that little film. I thought I'd tack on this little narrated section at the end just to answer any questions you might have regarding the trail, regarding, you know, our little camping spot, and just to have some sort of dialogue to fill in some of the gaps of what you just watched in that little film. So right at the end there, you saw us come to the top of the mountain, and there was a couple of toddlers. And my wife, when she watched the video, she was like, what the hell, what are they doing up there? I mean, you've just climbed this epic mountain over all these rocks and there's a couple of toddlers. Well, it just so happens there is a road that goes all the way to the top of Mount Buller. It's actually a ski resort, and there's a car park 100 meters from the summit. So you can drive up, park your car, walk up to the summit and show your kids the summit and stuff. So the other thing is there is a dot. You'll see it in some of the shots looking up at the sky on my on the sensor of my camera. It's a little dust particle or some sort of mark on the sensor. I can actually see it when I look at the sensor, take the lens off. And I've got a lens cleaning kit. I've actually got a proper kit to take it off, and I've tried a few times, but it just, this will not come off. So I've got to send the camera away to get professionally cleaned. So that's the other, that's the reason why there's a dot on the, some of the shots. Okay, so obviously the Mount Buller Walk is in Victoria, Australia. It's not far, it's about 2.5 hours drive from my home. And if we look at the All Trails map here, you can see I live around here somewhere. Hopefully you can see that cursor. And it's a 2-hour drive out through Eildon and through Mansfield. It's actually not through Eildon, it's through Mansfield. And then you head out to Mount Buller, which is out here where you can see the red line. And then if you zoom in, the West Ridge track leads along here, and it's actually a ridge walk, as it's pretty self-explanatory, to the top of Mount Buller. In the first few shots of the video, you saw us camping. We sort of camped overnight at Marimba. So this is really where the entry to, it's Mount Buller entry gates. So we were somewhere around here, very close to Marimba, just in the bushes, in the scrub next to the river here. And that was a beautiful little spot. I actually really enjoyed just chilling out, having a couple of beers. Obviously with this sort of thing, you gotta make sure you take all your rubbish with you. Leave no trace that you were there. Otherwise, you know, people can spoil it for the rest of us. But there were people camping at Marimba, and there's actually a proper, if you've got a proper camping setup, you can actually camp in and around here. And there's toilets and things like that at Mount Buller entry gates. There's also a playground for kids in here. So, you know, if you want to bring your kids, it's also fantastic. All right, if we step back and look at Marimba, where the track is, the West Ridge track here, you can actually walk up the West Ridge track and then walk down the Kingsbourne track, which goes down through here, back into Marimba. But you need two cars. You need, like James, obviously, James, my mate that was with me, he had his car, so he parked it at Marimba. We just parked at the end of the Kingsbourne track, which is right here. So he just parked in here. And then we drove my car out through here. and then up Doherty Road. So you come in through here, and then it's a dirt track. Be actually good for gravel riding if you wanted to take your bike out there and do some gravel riding. Quite a big climb. And then that's the start of the West Ridge track there. So we just parked our car, the other car there, and started the trail. So you can see in the first couple of shots here, there is a fork in the road. You go left, obviously, to go to the West Ridge, and it's clearly marked. You can see the markings on the ground. If you were to go right, it's pretty much a dead end. There's the intersection there, and then it's a dead end. So you can't mess it up. So the first part of the track is quite steep. I would say it's probably one of the two toughest parts of the whole track. It then flattens off through the nice and opens up along the ridge. So that's probably the most scenic section through the middle to the end of the West Ridge track. And then as you get up to Mount Buller, it steepens up again on some quite loose rocks. So they're probably the two toughest parts of the track. But look, personally, I'm not a hiker. I'm not a hiker at all. So for me, it was quite a challenge. And I don't do much walking. I do a lot of cycling. When I say a lot of cycling, maybe a couple of hundred Ks a week. So I was okay fit. But by the time I got to the Mount Buller, you can see in some of the shots where I'm eating the sandwiches, I was absolutely cooked, like I was proper in the herd house. So there are some great places to stop along the way. We stopped for lunch probably 3/4 away along the track, right on the top of the ridge, beautiful views either side. And so, you know, as James said, my mate James does a lot of hiking, and he said this is one of the most scenic hikes probably in Victoria, and I would have to agree with him. And I think you probably would too, looking at some of the footage. Now, from the top of Mount Buller, we actually hiked back down. You can get back down with the mountain bike buses, but we hiked down, and I can tell you, as a non-hiker, this was harder than hiking up. I've actually realized that hiking up a mountain is much, much easier than hiking down it, especially for someone like me. I'm 47 years old. The old knees are a bit tender. And so I found muscular on my muscles and on my joints really tough coming down the mountain. Now, James was going to take me down the Kingsbourne track, which is quite a famous track. Back in the old days, that's what they used to bring cattle up the mountain and things like that, because there were no roads in there. So it's quite a tough track, actually. But James took it one step further. He's ex-army, crazy, loves this sort of thing. So we actually went straight down the mountain from the top of Mount Buller. And we went down this ridge through here, and I would not recommend it. I would actually go further around here, and you actually see the Kingsbourne track go along here. I think that's it. If I zoom in, it's the blue one. So this is the Kingsbourne track here, and it actually takes you around. But we went down this black line, and I can tell you, mate, it was a tough going. There's a lot of tree branches, a lot of loose stones to trip over, slipping, sliding. You don't really have good sure footing. So I really struggled. And, you know, I mean, if you were to talk to James, he'd tell you that I pretty much whinged the whole way down. I was moaning and carrying on. It took us about an hour and a half just to get to the Kingsbourne track, straight down this ridge. And then once you get on the track, it's pretty easy going all the way back into Marimba. So, and that's where our second car was parked. So that was quite the Kingsbourne track I would recommend. Just in summary, don't go down this ridge unless you're very experienced and you want to go on some wild, crazy outback adventure. You know, some of the equipment that we took, obviously I had my Lumix GH5. I had the 12 to 35 lens on it. I had some spare batteries. I had my DJI Mavic 2 Pro Zoom with me, and James had his Hasselback version of that. So we had two drones. James, actually, there's one of the shots where you see the drone spinning around us on the ridge. Well, I reversed that clip. You might be able to tell by some of my hand movements, but it was actually going the other way. And what it did is it swung around, and because James didn't have the proximity sensors on, it slammed straight into the side of the mountain. And started tumbling down the mountain. So fortunately he broke a couple of rotor blades, but the drone itself was in perfect condition, which was a good result. And the other thing we had in the backpacks was quite a bit of food. So I had three sandwiches, just cheese and Vegemite, and some fruit. Had a couple of apples and some muesli bars. but you don't need too much. I think I took a little bit more food than I needed simply because we were going to be out there for a little bit longer due to the filming. So yeah, look, in summary, I bit off more than I can chew with this walk. I mean, really, it's for experienced, fit hikers. Mate, I have seriously been limping around for 4 days now, probably 5 days. I've had DOMS, delayed onset muscle soreness, through my you know, hamstrings and calves. But, you know, as James said, it was well worth it, man. It was an awesome hike. And James has done, you know, being ex-army, he sort of loves getting out there in the wilderness. You can follow him here on Instagram, but you can see a lot of his footage that he takes and some of the photos that he takes while he's solo camping. He goes camping in the snow and all sorts of things. And he's done quite a few of these walks. And he said, look, it's one of the best without a doubt. He's done it 5 or 6 times. So that's it, legends. I hope you enjoyed this video. I do have another video coming about the Melbourne to Warrnambool coming up soon. A bit of history. And we were fortunate to do the ride with Simon Gerrans, Phil Anderson, you know, some big names of Australian cycling. And that was pretty awesome. So I've got some great footage. Look forward to bringing that video to you in the next, let's say the next month, but hopefully it's like in the next week. And I hope to make more videos in 2020. So if you hung around this long for the video, legends, thank you for coming back and watching, and I will hopefully see you in the next one.